Now, what I know is Professor Tiwari is a very well-known art historian and has done extensive work in the field of Jain art. And he was also heading the Department of Art History over here. And plus, he's also extremely dynamic in organizing a Congress of History of Art, Indian Art Congress, yes. And has done extensive writing in the field of Jain art and Indic art as a whole. So, all aspects of Indian art. So he's going to be speaking about some aspects of manifestation of nature and symbols in Indian art, much broader concept. And I guess he's trying to relate the images with nature. Okay.
Thank you very much. I'm really grateful to the organizers for giving me this opportunity to present the paper in this seminar, which is a seminar of integrated nature, to see the parallels between art, science, and philosophy. Of course, they are interrelated. And this morning, Professor Madhu Khanna has said that every study should be integrated one. It should be inclusive, apart from being exclusive. And also, it should have a sense of convergence. So in my presentation, both by way of symbols as well as the form, I will show how the nature was playing role, vital role, throughout in a very integrated way, as well as the symbols which are mentioned in the ancient scriptures from the Vedas. We have a reference to swastik, chakra, lotus. And the journey starts, which comes through the visual form. So I will be speaking more with the non-verbal language, in non-verbal language of art. And it is the present as well. Because every study which pertains to past now is being questioned as to its relevance in present context. Why should we study? Now, I have reasons. I have examined, I have studied the whole of Indian art in a holistic and integrated perspective. And I could find out the reasons in the very concept of all the forms which pertain to something of social relevance, which was relevant not in the context of past, but equally or rather more relevant in the present. So that way the continuity and integration, I would be like focusing. We have been talking right since this morning. We have the words like prakriti and vikriti. Prakriti is unmanifest, that is nirguna nirakar, formless. And it is said that he means the ultimate, that Brahma, Paramatma, who is formless, invisible, manifests in himself into many forms. For the sake of the convenience of the people, so that they could take them as they wish. Be it Buddha, be it Vishnu, Shiva, be it Jain Tirthankar. So this was the very basic concept of prakriti and vikriti, which we find throughout in Indian art, philosophy, and of course in the science also. Because one has to get into one point, because she has been talking about primeval womb, Bindu. with a sense of hesitation, I am tempted to put that we have the example. In case of motherhood, what is that which comes in the womb? Is it not primeval womb? It is the part of the whole which is being carried in the womb of the mother. Hardly any form. It could be bindu, it could be pind. Pind and Brahman relationship. But when it comes out, it has a form and it gradually grows. So every study has to be seen in terms of growing and developing, right from bindu to different forms, be it geometrical, be it human form with geometrical concepts behind it, one thing. And second is that we have the concept of temples. In Vedic Puranic tradition, Shaivism, Vaishnavism, Shaktism, Jainism, and subsequently even in Buddhism. What is Garbhagriha? Again, that Garbhagriha, Sanctum Sanctorum. Again, one, primeval womb. And out of that Garbhagriha, when one comes out, he just see the explosion of forms. Divine world, human world, animal world, flora and fauna, but not. So this is to be viewed how from one to many was the main point, whether it is to be seen in terms of bindu or pind to Brahmand or in any other concept. To deal with the sculpture or any form of manifestation of Indian art, one must know the art of communicating with the silence. This is very important. Maun or Khamosh. The same is with the science. Whenever we have an interaction or we are in search of knowledge or knowing something, we have to communicate with silence. So here is the art. And for that, we must enter into the very concept of the forms. She has rightly pointed out what Kumaraswamy has written. But that is Kumaraswamy on the basis of the text, South Indian text, very specifically and in detail says how a sculptor, an architect goes in isolation, then meditation, then conceptualizing the form, then comes out with the form. So this is almost called a sadhana. Then dhyana mantra. Dhyana mantra, therefore it is called dhyana mantra. Both human and symbols and the presence of nature, whether it is a Buddha, Tirthankar, or even Shiva, Vishnu, Brahma, Saraswati, or even symbols like swastik, chakra, called dharma chakra, in the form of Surya, it is with Vishnu, it is with Buddha, it is Jain Tirthankar. Kalash, Shrivas, Triratna, Trikshatra, these all have geometrical form. Lines, squares, circles, and they connote philosophical meaning. I will just show you gradually. In Buddhist and Jain art, these symbols are non-sectarian in character. This is very important. And denote the concept of welfare, that is mangal of all. This is the purpose of all putting all the symbols. Why at all any manifestation took place? Why at all anything was conceptualized? Of course, for the society and the human being, and for its well-being. And I would gradually show, when I go with these slides, one thing is very important, that usually we saw we find Srivas on Jain Ayagapat, or in Jain context as cognizance of Jain Tirthankar, or in Buddhist context, Chakra or Dharma Chakra in Buddhist or even Jain context, we say Jain symbol, Buddhist symbol. It is a circle. Circle which represents the entirety, the Brahmand, the movement, the radiation, and the earliest form one could see was in the form of the Surya. Where from does circle come? We have made a study that this comes out of that. But Surya was there. Directly Surya was there. And the form was taken from that. So all the symbols are non-sectarian in character. Unka apna koi vyaktigat dharma nahi hota. Only with reference to the context they become Jain, they Buddhist or Brahminical. If they are in the hand of Vishnu, and it is the time, it is the kal, it is called chakra, time, because it always moves. And it has been the very essential of the culture and civilization right from the remote past. You know, that in the form of the wheel. So it becomes chakra. And chakra with movement, what does it do? Or what does he did? He killed the demons, the persons doing wrong, and that is the kal. Then it becomes the kal, time. The time is over. That moves. In case of Buddhism and Jainism, again the same circle is there with the spokes. The number of spokes, again the lines are there, they are very relevant. In Sarnath, you are very much here. Just visit Ashokan Lion Pillar and just count how many spokes does it have. 24. The time. 24 hours. Movement. That is life. That was then, that was even earlier, and that is even today. हम यही अब 24 घंटे में ही अपने को बांधते हैं, वही हमारी गति है, वही हमारे विकास का आधार है, धुरी है. Why it is put on Buddhist image or Jain image, Jain Tirthankar? Because dharma, or you say religion, which is not exact translation, was never static in Indian context. It was always moving, changing with the time. And therefore, when it is shown on the pedestal, that represents, symbolizes the dharma. Buddha is not going to speak in the image. He is in the preaching posture, dharma chakra pravartan. And on the pedestal you find dharma chakra. Means, it will symbolize the outcome of the preaching of Buddha, which becomes the dharma, means the code of conduct of life. And that life has to be mobile, not static. Therefore, you find dharma chakra always moving. So now I just move with the visuals. The flora and fauna forming nature with water, fire, earth, sky and wind, pancha tattva, five primeval elements, occupy a substantial and integrated, that is samprikt, place in the total plethora of Indian art. Virtually Indian art is the integrated visual manifestation of human and non-human nature and geometrical design centering around square, rectangle, triangle, circle, of course the dot, which could be seen in the form of the temples, Samavasaran, I will just show Ayagpat, and even today when we have Karva Chauth, Deepavali. Why? We should bring everything to the present. to bring the relevance of our tradition of the past. It was not at all relevant, it was never meant for only for certain period of time. Just you see Diwali, you will find sun, you will find moon, you will find snake, all the presence of the nature. And sun, moon, right from there, right from images, Tirthankar is just preaching. And in that posture, you will find sun and moon. What does it denote? Shashwat, perennial impact of the preachings. Symbolic suggestions, the form is there. One is crescent, again line, circle. And even today, what do we say? Aapne vivah geet kabhi suna hai? Vivah ki marriage song. Usme yahi kaha jata, wish kiya jata hai, ki jab tak suraj chand rahe, tab tak tumhara suhag rahe. Aur netaon ka jab swagat kiya jata hai, they are also welcome, then also said, jab tak suraj chand rahega, phalane neta tumhara naam rahega. मैं किसी का नाम ले लूंगा तो मैं फिर आइडेंटिफाई हो जाऊंगा तो दिस इज द कंटिन्यूटी वो आपके उसमें आज तक उस क्रम में चल रहा है इंडियन आर्ट डेवलप्ड इन द बैकड्रॉप ऑफ एंड इन एसोसिएशन विथ नेचर टू ट्रांसमिट इन नॉन वर्बल लैंग्वेज द स्ट्रांग मैसेज हाउ ह्यूमैनिटी एंड डिवाइन वर्ल्ड कुड एग्जिस्ट only with nature and symbols of global wellness. Nahi to matlab kya hai? There is no meaning. There should be some purpose. Purpose was there to just serve the society. Every religion, every science, every philosophy is for humanity. So if it does not serve humanity when it was thought of or even in the present, then it will become irrelevant in the present, at least. This is swastik. Can anybody tell me its affiliation? No. It is swastik. It is lines, double swastik is there. Likewise, you have shown triangle. As well as it becomes a square, and even the lines also become a square. And it has the suggestion. Swasti bhava, the very, very inherent concept of Indian tradition of wellness of all, welfare of all, the happiness of all. Sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu niramaya. Ye baad mein aaya. Swastik we get in the Vedas, Vedic times. और ये स्वस्तिक है 11th सेंचुरी का ये जैन मंदिर में है तो जैन मंदिर में है वहां जैन कॉन्टेक्स्ट हो गया बट स्वस्तिक इज नॉट जैन हमने यही काम किया है वी आर बॉर्न एज ए ह्यूमन बीइंग और टैग हो गया कि मैं हिंदू हूं यू आर मुस्लिम यू आर वैष्णव आई एम शैव नो इससे लाभ हुआ है कि नुकसान हुआ है हमको आपको सोचना है आर्ट फिलॉसफी साइंस आपको बराबर ऑलवेज यू आर रिमाइंडेड ऑफ द फैक्ट दैट वी आर ऑल बेसिकली ह्यूमन बींग्स मीन्स इक्वल टैग तो बाद में लग गया कपड़े से लग गया दाढ़ी से लग गया बाल से लग गया नो तो इसका कोई धर्म नहीं सिंबल्स आपको यह सिखाता है और इंपॉर्टेंट यह है कि ये दिस स्वस्तिक इज फाउंड On Jain images, Tirthankar images of Kushan period from Mathura, inscribed. The images of Tirthankar, or it is on Ayagapat, square, again square, Puja Shilapat, meant for worship. Worship of the Arhat or the Tirthankaras. Arhat means eligible. Or we find that the inscription says that this is the image of Vardhaman or this is Ayagapat installed for the worship of Tirthankar. Then it says in Prakrit Sabva jan hitaye, sabva jan sukhaye. Just see the motto. I'm not saying. The inscription of the 1st-2nd century AD says, for the welfare and happiness of all, it was carved, it was installed. And now what we have done? We have narrowed down the very, very basic principle and concept of religion and the form. And we know, how do we define ourselves? So these are the forms which give us the lesson. Not only the visual feast nahi hai ye ki aap dekh lijiye ya just see the image of Buddha and offer your obeisance. No. Buddha, Tirthankar, obeisance, Vishnu, no. Just get something out of that. Bhakti doesn't mean, bhakti means your complete identification, nirbhara bhakti kahte hain usko, Ramcharit Manas mein aaya hai. Complete, total, you are lost, your identity is lost. And then you get inspired from the form. And the form, which is visual, has the concept. The Vishnu image is not going to speak. But the concept will tell you what, for what does the form stand. Circle, which to my mind started right from the sun. It's a form. Very direct thing was there. Jain Ayagapat, and here you find Dharma Chakra. Here is the circle. This morning snack was shown. Here you see, so beautiful. Here from Ranakpur Jain Temple. Circle with a number of snacks, and in its midst stand Sahasrapana Parshvanath. It is circle Rang Mandap. And the lotus petals 16 are there, and on the back, on front of it, we can see 16 Mahavidyas. We have talked about in Jainism also, we have a very vigorous concept of mantra and yantra. And here you see the Rang Mandap and the 16 Mahavidyas in the backdrop of this. Again, chakra having 24 spokes. Here again, Sanchi Chakra. This is Sarnath. I'm not going to explain the symbolism of four lines, otherwise if we take hours and hours I can do, because only I am just focusing on these points. Here you see Dharma Chakra. Not put like that, static, in movement, because Dharma Chakra Pravartan, he just preached and put the wheel in motion. Because Dharma is not static, Dharma has to move, because Upanishad said, Charaiveti, Charaiveti, Charaiveti. So the holistic perspective we should take now. Holistic. Interplay of philosophy, science and art. Art is what? Art is the visual manifestation of what was in concept in philosophy and what was thought of in scientific temper. It is not that science just in 20th century started science. No. So the science of medicine, science of music, everything we find it was in tradition, but now the progression has to be there, like Dharma Chakra. So that is there. So you see here. Now the nature. Can you see both the images? What do you think? These two are two different images. These are one, and here see the nature. Only I have removed this circular prabhamandal, I have removed, and beautifully done with foliage or creepers. So beautiful. I have removed, and you see the grace, 70% grace is gone. So this is how the nature came forward to beautify the forms, to give the spiritual grace impact also. And this is also to be seen in terms of nature. The commonality I was talking about, here again, Dharma Chakra. Here again, in Jain context, Dharma Chakra. And wonderful symbolism. On two sides of Dharma Chakra of the Jain image, as we find in case of Sarnath Buddha images and a number of other Buddha images from other places, that Dharma Chakra is flanked by two deers. That, to my mind, does not relate to Mrigadav. That has greater meaning, and greater meaning in the sense of peace, because it flanks, they flank the Dharma Chakra, which is the Dharma. Dharma is the preaching, the code of conduct, and that Dharma only bring peace to the humanity, peace of mind, heart, and words. And that peace is being suggested by two deers. So this is the language of art, the silent language of art. How to understand, we can see. And that was, in Buddhism it started, and Jainism also accepted it in the same spirit. These are two figures. Are we able to identify the figures? If we remove these two natural animals, if we remove, we are not able to just see the flow of water. Makar Vahini Ganga and Kurma Vahini Yamuna. Just see the association. Aquatic animal with river goddesses. Why not lion? So there was a rationale. In every form, in every symbol, the nature was integrated, and through the nature, a suggestion was given which facilitates the identification, and also that makes the representation meaningful. Here, it is written Abhishek Lakshmi. We call Gaja Lakshmi, that is wrong, because the terms also we use very casually. Anyway, that is another point. You see, Lakshmi holds lotus. We know in Tantra you have shown Sri Yantra, the role of lotus is there in every Tantra Yantra. But Lakshmi invariably holds lotus, and being illustrated by two elephants. If we remove two elephants and this lotus, how are we going to identify Lakshmi? No. She will become simply a lady. Theek. Just looking at the grace, we may say that, oh yes, she must be some goddess. But some goddess, who is she? We can't. Means, the nature that lotus and elephant have given the identification to the goddess. This is the relevance of the nature. I have just showing only few examples. In all the cases, Ganga, Yamuna, you remove this and you remove. And again, why elephant? Lakshmi is the goddess of prosperity and wealth, and elephant stands for prosperity. Raja hi hathi rakh sakta hai. Aaj bhi hamare yahan kahawat hai. Hathi rakha to samajhte hain ki raja hai kya? And lotus represents the fullness of life. So this is integration of form and the natural symbols. another very dynamic form, rectangular framing, is Mahish Mardini, very dynamic. But again, you see, the Mahishasur is shown with face of a buffalo, while the goddess rides a lion. The dimensions through the geometrical linings, you see that the goddess is above the ground level. Means she is fighting from the sky. And he stands on the ground. And because of this perspective, this is art. Because of this perspective, artists, just think of the artist. Nowadays, I'm afraid any artist can make such images. Pallav art, Mahabalipuram. Just you see the size, the dimension of the figure and here. Because the perspective is that the goddess is here, the demon is here, so he has to be longer than the goddess one. So all these perspectives and the representation of the animals, the plants, the vegetation could be seen. This is a very important temple from of Jinnathpur, Jain temple, of course it is.
Where is that?
Shravanbelgol, Karnataka. In the center you see the Parshvanath. He represents the highest point of his spirituality, renunciation, sadhana. Well, because part and whole, and holistic and integrated life, it gives the message, this temple wall gives the message of the complete and holistic life. On one point in the center you find the symbol of austerity, renunciation, Parshvanath. He stands in Kayas Sarga. But on the other hand, the beautiful musicians, Chamar Dharini, Apsaras, undrapping, Vivastra Jagana. We must use the technical, real textual terms here itself. Dancer. And what, and more important is the representation of the goddess of love, Kamdev. He is on the wall of a temple wherein in the center is being occupied by Vitaragi Tirthankar. So this is the view, the philosophy of the concept of the life. Jo kehte hain na ki keval ye sanyas, moksh, palayan, no. They were not for living the world. It was propounded dharma, artha, kama, moksha. It is to be identified in temples. All the purusharthas are being represented. And moreover, you see the form beautified by the presence of the flowing if you remove all this, the beauty, half of the beauty will go. So this is how, in art, in temples, the nature always came forward to beautify the form. And we know from the Kalidas that all the limbs were taken from different elements of nature. If eye of a yogi is to be shown, it should be like a lotus. Eye of a apsara is to be the naika is to be shown, it has to be of a deer, chanchala. So from, this is how the nature was always overwhelmingly present in all the manifestations of art, irrespective of any religious affiliation. Kamadeva, two figures, one from Khajuraho, Parshvanath Jain temple, another is just what you have seen, Shantinath temple of Jinnathpur. How to identify Rati and Preeti? How to identify with Kamadeva? If I remove this, we won't be able to identify the figure. Again, the nature is there. The attributes, the vehicles or the vahanas, the surroundings, they are all formed of the nature. And the nature only could give meaning and identification to the forms. What is this? Ikshudhanu, the bow of sugar cane, and panch pushpa shar, five arrows made of different flowers, lotus, mango, ashok, like this. Just think, Kamdev is the god of love. And the sweetest experiences of love for anybody in life, and the sweetest thing of nature is nothing else but sugar cane. So it has been shown with him. And it is the flower, still today, kya hai, garden mein ja rahe hain. What for? Flowers. तो जो फ्लावर्स हैं आज भी हमको अट्रैक्ट करते हैं स्नेह के लिए, काम के लिए, प्रेम के लिए, और इसलिए वो पंच पुष्प शर लेकर के खड़े होते हैं. अरे और तो और उनके साथ मकर ध्वज दिखाया जाता है. एंड डू यू नो मकर ध्वज का आयुर्वेद में क्या मतलब है? मकर ध्वज का मतलब ही दूसरा है, इट मेक्स पोटेंट. तो वो पूरा का पूरा जो एक आइकोनोग्राफी या आइकोनोलॉजी फॉर्म होता था, वो नेचर के थ्रू आके ही मीनिंग पाता था. सो ऑल परवेडिंग नेचर जो रहा है वो थ्रू आउट हम इसमें देखते हैं. मैं जल्दी करूंगा. ये टेम्पल है, ये नैरेटिव्स हैं, पूरे रामायण महाभारत की कथाएं हैं यहां, देखिए. फिर डीटीज हैं अबव, यू फाइंड. ये है होयसलेश्वर टेम्पल, हलेबिड, कर्नाटक, 11th century. यहाँ आप देखें रोज ऑफ एलिफेंट्स, हॉर्सेस एंड देन क्रीपर्स. सो द फ्लोरा एंड फाना मेड द इंटायर टेम्पल सरफेस, बीट वॉल, बीट बेसमेंट, अधिष्ठान, ब्यूटिफुल. ह्यूमन फॉर्म हो, डिटीज का फॉर्म हो, ऊपर भी आपको मिलेगा पूरा का पूरा नेचर. और ये तो मैंने इसलिए दिखा दिया कि इट इज द ओनली एंशियंट सर्वाइविंग टेम्पल ऑफ काशी वाराणसी, 12th century, कर्दमेश्वर टेम्पल. वन मस्ट, इफ यू हैव नॉट विजिटेड यू शुड गो. कर्दमेश्वर शिव. अगेन महाबलीपुरम, यू सी गंगावतरण, द डिसेंट ऑफ गंगा, रिवर गंगा. द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ माउंटेन, यू सी रेक्टेंगुलर फॉर्मेशन. सो ज्योमेट्री हैज टू बी देयर इन एवरी फॉर्म, हैज टू बी देयर. आप शेप फॉर्म कैसे देंगे उसके बिना? सो दैट हैज टू बी देयर इनहेरेंट. एंड इन द मिडिल यू सी द रिफ्ट, फ्लो ऑफ वाटर, अलॉन्ग विथ कम्स डाउन द स्नेक्स. On this part, you find the elephant, best representation of animal, it is said, Benjamin Roland has said, is to be seen in Pallav art, and particularly at Mahabalipuram, and particularly in this great panel. And you see, they have got the nature of elephant. Hathi jab chalta hai, to uske bachche uske pair ke beech mein chalte hain, ye dekhiye. शिशु हाथी, द चाइल्ड एलिफेंट्स. गंगा के किनारे का दृश्य है. वन कैन फाइंड द रेट्स ओवर हियर एंड ए विडाल ऑफ कैट इन पेनांस. पंचतंत्र की कथा है. एंड दिस सीन परटेन्स टू गंगावतरण, देयर फोर यू फाइंड भगीरथ, शिव, Bhagirath in penance, you can see. Then worshipping in the temple, Shiva temple. And here are the scenes which are very usual to be usually to be seen on the bank of River Ganges. One is just offering pranam or namaskar, Surya pranam. Another one is just going with a pitcher, water pitcher, which he has collected from the Ganga. And I have identified that I could underline the time also in silence. And the time is of the morning. Because it is in the morning time only that such activities goes on the bank of Ganga. And here you can see one just takes Ganga water and also the Surya Namaskar on the bank of Ganga. And the entire representation shows the mood of gaiety, happiness over coming of Ganga to the earth. And another is, you see, so beautiful. Deer. Deer ka jo best pose hota hai, wo hai apne khur se naak ko sehlane ka. With its front part of the leg, it just touches and does it like that. And that has been captured by the artist. So, through the representation of nature, through the presence of, kyunki jo geometrical form hai, wo form mein hi to frame hoga. Frame to aapko karna hi hai. So frame has to come from some or the other geometrical form. It is there. And this is again one of the brilliant creation of Indian art. This is from Ellora, and this comes from Shravan Belgol. What is the beauty? Beauty is the suggestion of the coexistence of man and nature. Coexistence of man and nature, you see, so integrated. Here, so integrated. And here one finds the anthills out of which come the snakes. The deer is here. And few images from Devgarh in Uttar Pradesh, I have seen the snakes, scorpions, lizards creeping over the body.
Yes.
What does it show? That if you are not going to make any harm to them, they are not going to make any harm. So this eco-friendly representations, ecological violence, what about we are so much concerned today, has throughout been represented in Indian art. To give the message, we worship Tulsi, we worship Neem, we worship people. What is that? That is not past, it is the present. Pure Kartik Maha mein, hum apne ghar ki baat batate hain, ki ghar mein Tulsi ji rakhi jati hain, ji hi mein dekhe mare muh se nikla. Aur pratidin diya jalaya jata hai aur puja ki jati hai. Kyon? We could realize only when we came to know of the medical property of Tulsi. Aur jab wo wahan se wo ho gaya. So all these are so important points of Indian art. Nature, geometrical pattern, symbols, and all are relevant human forms, and all are relevant in the context of the present. Therefore, our past is so much relevant for all of us today. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for this lovely overview on relationship between nature and art, and showing us such beautiful slides and the detailing in each of them, that ultimately Indian art is about creation and inspired from nature.
Definitely.
So, and also it's telling us some of the most important values of human life, how to live in perfect, I would say, harmony with nature.
I have given you the just glimpses. Otherwise,
yes, yes.
All the virtuous qualities which are taken to be the ideals, we are taken by the religion and we are represented in visual art, not only in the shastras.
Yes, wonderful. So now may I open the for discussion, if there are any questions. Yes, please, yes.
Be at mic, please. Huh?
Yes. Sir, I felt that the whole presentation was full of generalization. So I'm coming from the beginning, like you were telling about the Surya Chandra Dekhkar, fir wo representation or circle ka aane laga. But like the there is whole area of Jomia, you must have heard, James Scott's book, The Art of Not Being Governed. So from northeast, it runs into Myanmar, northern Thailand, part of southwest China. You don't find circle in any of their representation. So they are not living in darkness. Naturally, they also see sun and moon. So why there is no representation of circle either in their textile or in any art form of the Jomia? So
I should generalize. go one by one. You are supporting my view because this does not go against what I have said. We have adopted. Somebody has not adopted. Not adopting anything doesn't mean anything.
But we can't say because we observe this, therefore everyone observing this will do. Because you are talking in terms of Indic things. So even they are part of India, geographically if you say. So we have to take that into account. Second thing was like you were saying in the Dhan Chakra, the 24 spokes, those are 24 ghanta, that is not ghanta, sir. Because there was no ghanta at that time. People were using ghati, vighati, nadi, vinadi. There was no concept of ghanta during the Buddha time, Ashoka time, or even up to 10th century, 11th century, Kal Chakra Tantra. It is always ghati, and so up it is 60 ghati.
What do you say, up to 10th century?
Yes, sir. I'm talking about Kal Chakra Tantra.
There was no concept of 24 hour.
No. It was always in terms of all calculation, all major astronomical texts. Luckily, I've gone through all texts in original from 6th century onward. So there is no concept of ghanta in any calculation. Basically, this 24 was the 24 avatara that came from 12 months. So aroh, avroh, okay, kram and utkram, that becomes 24. So please don't link it with the concept of ghanta.
Let me answer then. One by one. That would be better. Yes, if the concept was not there, I accept. Thick. Second is, what you have said is not correct. Because by 3rd century BC, the concept of 24 Buddhas was not there. Then how can you are doing the same thing? You are applying the same methodology.
But Mahavir was 24 Tirthankar, that everyone knows.
In case of Buddhism, Mahavir you are applying.
No. What I am saying, the concept is there, no, sir. One concept that percolates two different dimensions, like Dham Chakra you are showing. Another query was like you are saying, jab tak Suraj Chand rahega, or Sadi rahega, Netaji rahenge. But the thing is, ki every culture don't talk in term of that. Like within India, I'm talking, Lepcha. When there is marriage, they don't talk about Suraj Chand ki Sadi. They say, ya hamara Rangoli Nadi, or jaise ya Tista Nadi ka Sadi hota hai, waise aapki Sadi rahe. So they talk in terms of rivals. So, we cannot generalize. That was my point.
Let me answer again. Actually, this is a pan-Indian concept. One thing, sir, and in all the forms, Kohbar form. Have you seen Kohbar?
Yes.
In Kohbar, Surya and the sun and the moon is there.
They are there.
You can't say like
but
that.
I'm thinking, we cannot generalize that it is always there. What I'm thinking, we can
say... I have not said that each and every person...
Our religion is not India.
Privilege of the chair. 1 minute. You see, the thing is, these are archetypal symbols and they transcend their cultural boundaries. And sun and moon, even the circular disc as sun is found in almost all cultures of the world. Swastika in its dynamic form is also considered to be a solar symbol in all cultures. So I guess, you know, and this cannot be a criticism. I mean, you never know. You may not have seen something, but some image will be there which will resemble. These are all archetypes and they transcend cultures, you know, sun and moon symbols in diagrams.
Then you are eliminating
the majority.
I'm talking about the northern Thailand, Burma, and whole the Jomia region, sir. I can say from my own work, Himalayan Bridge is that come in 2016. So it's an elaborate discussion on that aspect. In last, I have lot of queries. Like you were saying about Kamdev, so Kamdev having this pushpa and then again generalization ki hum garden kyun jate. But Kamdev is not only pushpa and this, it is basically Gandh Shastra. So,
which Shastra?
Gandh, fragrance, smell, perfume,
fragrance.
And there was a lot of aromatic science which got developed. Mukhvas bhi hota tha, nahane ka bhi hota tha, malish ka bhi hota tha. So different kind of things. So the thing is, what happened, the iconography, it was not catching up with the discoveries or the works which were coming in different disciplines. So I think somewhere iconography was left behind and science had got developed. Therefore, there is no representation of other kind of symbolism for this in our sculptures.
No, what is that other kind you're imagining?
Actually, what like, you have said is...
Why we are using only the pusp for the kante? Why not this mukhvas kind of thing?
No, but you are not the artist.
No, what I am saying, iconography was not catching up with the new sciences.
But you know, five is because he's got five functions, attraction and, you know...
Five senses.
That is why he's got five.
I did not have that much of time. I could have talked Kamadev 1 hour on only Kamadev.
And then, you know...
I could have talked on Ganshastra.
Yes, but that is another subject. We'll need another seminar for it, Neeraj ji. Ganshastra ke liye. Okay. Yeah, we can discuss. What has happened is that this is a real seminar. One aspect of Indian art has been discussed, and out of that, 10 more are coming out. So I think it's very creative way of responding. But I'm afraid I'll have to ask you to ask your questions at dinner time for the simple reason.
After
because
dinner.
we have another presentation. Are there any more questions? Any more questions? Well, I thought you brought in...
He has covered all.
No, maybe there is some other question. Rana ji, aapke, what about...
Hello.
How these symbols enter the microcosm? You know, the images of the yoga images and microcosm is also very interesting.
Very important.
Yeah.
So many aspects.
Yeah, but what is interesting is that as Stella Kramish has also said, you know, that Indian art is not about nature, but nature itself. You see, that is a very famous statement she made. It is not about creation, but creation itself. Or about nature, but nature
that
itself.
That is what I think.
So that is what has come through. And there's another dimension of the way art is represented. So thank you very much, Maruti ji, and we will... Okay, may